random with no repeats. Well, it's been 11 years since this video and things have changed. In this video, I'm going to show you how to choose 8 names from a list of 26 names, some number of names from a list of who knows how many, choose 5 numbers from 1 to 69 and another from 1 to 26, generate many Powerball selections. All right, so over here we have a list of 26 names and I want to randomly choose 8 of those. Starting from the inside, we're going to sort that range to sort and we're going to generate a random array of 26 numbers. That's because there's 26 items in the list over here. This is going to generate essentially the entire list in a new sort, but then we only want the top 8. So I ask for the index of the sequence of 8. So this formula right here will create a random list. We press F9 to get a new list. Now, it would help, I think, to think about this as 2 distinct steps. The first thing we're doing is we're shuffling the original deck of cards into a brand new list. So we're sorting that list by a random array of 26 items. Once we have that sorted, then we want only the top 8 from the list. So the index function, and this is generating the numbers 1 to 8 for us. See, right there, 1 to 8. All right, so it's 2 basic steps. Now, let's make this a little bit more flexible. So over here we have a list of employees. We want to choose 5 of those. To allow for more people to be added later, I'm going to make it into a table with Control T, click OK, and they're going to give it a horrible name of Table 3. I'll just call this Names. How about that? That name should be short, should be one word, no spaces. And then we're going to count. So equal count A, that will count text as well as numbers. Select the range, and they put in the table name for us. If you name your table something different or had a different heading, it'll just automatically appear there. And then the number to choose. All right, so made the list into a table, gave the list a short but meaningful name, used count A to figure out how many items we have, entered how many we wanted there in E4. And then I'm gonna do this in 2 steps. We're gonna do equals sort by. This is the range to sort, name's name. And we're going to do a rand array of 10 items. And so every time I press F9, that will reorder the list of people. And then I want to come back and edit this and add the index function in because I only want the top 5. I'm not going to hard code the 5. I'm going to point to that cell. All right, so now every time I press F9, I get a different 5. And if we add more people later and change the number to choose, so here's the top 3, here's the top 10, here's everybody, all 19, right? So very flexible. Now I realize that one of the reasons why that first video was so popular is that people are trying to generate lotto numbers, right? Which is, you know, a great way to go. If you know that you want the numbers 1 to 69, we don't have to put the numbers in the worksheet like we did with the names. We can just generate the numbers 1 to 69 here using the sequence function. And then a rand array of 69 numbers and the sort by. And then finally we want to choose 5 of those to get our lotto numbers. And then if you're playing the Powerball, you need a 6th number, the Powerball, random number between 1 and 26. The formula that's down in the YouTube description that you can just copy into your spreadsheet does a few more things. Once it gets those 5 numbers, it sorts them. Joins them with commas in between, adds the Powerball to the end. This formula is a great formula. You just copy it from the YouTube description and paste and then drag down and there are your lotto picks. Just recently I was updating the thumbnail images for the top 10 and I looked at some of these, they're really old, and I said, oh, we need to update these. I'll be going through the others as we go. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like this video, please visit tl.page/MrExcel. Scroll down, you'll find my group lessons and plenty more videos. Thanks for watching.